Another Cyber Monday. Yeah, it's in the books. Looks like it was a good one, too. A lot of money spent out there. According to Adobe Analytics, shoppers spent more than, are you ready for this, $6.5 billion. That's about as much as they thought they would be spending. In fact, it was the largest online sales day in history. We're going to have much more on Cyber Monday sales coming up at 9:30 with our business expert in New York. Right now, let's check in with Amy.
All right. Thanks, Bob. This morning's Consumer Corner from Black Friday to Cyber Monday. Shoppers swiping those credit cards to check off their long holiday shopping list. Now, according to NerdWallet's 2017 Consumer Holiday Shopping Report, Americans will spend an average of about $660 this year. But if you head into the season of giving and you don't have a budget, there's a good chance you are going to come out on the other side with a holiday hangover in the form of debt. And here now is some saving strategies and how to handle all that credit card debt is our good friend and savings angel, Josh Hall. It's great to see you, Josh.
Yes, thanks
for
being here. Thank you so much,
Amy. Okay, so let's talk about this because I think that we all go into it with a plan, right? Mm-hmm. Or try to anyway.
Well, not everybody.
Right? Not everybody.
Actually, only about three quarters go
You're
into
kidding.
It. But yeah,
okay.
About 27% do not have
no
a budget.
At all.
No plan at all, no
but
budget.
Don't you find, Josh, that what happens is, and I know I'm guilty of it too, is that I get towards that last minute shopping and then I'm like, oh, I just have to have something and I just start spending, right?
Yeah.
And that's what happens when you don't have a plan.
Yeah, that's very, very common. So, again, the thing that you want to do ahead of time, this is what we did with our boys, with all three of our kids, in fact, is that we said, you know, look, you know, and it almost feels like you're not being magical by saying this, but I said, son, you know, kids, you've got, this is your budget.
Yeah.
And so when you ask for stuff, it needs to fit within this budget. And now we kind of add all that up. We know exactly what we're going to spend. We have a plan for paying it off, and it's not going to involve paying it off for over a year because it's on a credit card balance, unlike a lot of other people.
Well, and what I like about that too, Josh, is you're teaching them those good values at a young age so that, that they grow up knowing, okay, well, everything doesn't, you know, grow on trees and it's not free and it costs money and here's how these things actually get into my house, right?
Yes, absolutely. And of course, you know, from mom and dad's perspective, we're avoiding credit card debt, which is sadly, gosh, it was 24% of millennials still paying for Christmas 2016. 16% of Gen Xers like myself are paying for Christmas last year. And baby boomers, while they're the most likely to use credit cards, are actually a little bit more responsible about paying it off.
So what is a good rule of thumb? So do you have to say, okay, this is how much money I make, this is how much I want to spend, or what is the rule of thumb for people to use?
Well, so you're going to know better than anybody what fits within your budget. And again, what I would do is I would make sure that you're designing the budget with the plan to pay in mind. And you have to be realistic about what your budget is. So you're looking at January, February, March. Where's the money coming from? And you have to divide that up into what you're going to spend in December. And you can't just throw caution to the wind because it's the holidays. And what this also means, Amy, is that we have to turn down those special offers at the register when people say, oh, well, would you like 15% off today? Would you like a free shopping pass? You have to be disciplined and learn to say no, because the number one thing that that's going to cause you to do is spend money outside of your budget. It's not free money.
Right.
And we have to remind ourselves of that.
Well, because a lot of times, and people don't read the fine print, you sign up for a store credit card and not realizing that it's at 25% interest rate sometimes.
Oh, absolutely. Oh, it's always, it's always at north of 20%.
Yeah.
Now, what they'll do is they'll say, well, it's free for, say, 3 months or 6 months or something like that. And then, of course, you get into the high interest rate. Well, if you're paying 23% interest rate, that's going to that's going to offset any potential savings that you had at the beginning. So you want to be very careful of that. And if you do find yourself with an accumulation of credit card debt, look, there are some really good tools today that you can use. You can go to like a website like credible.com has like a shopping where you can compare like gazillion different credit card offers or even low interest loans so that you could take your existing debt and you can transfer that into a 0% balance. You could play this game if you're really, really smart about it, but I'm just telling you, be careful.
Yeah, because you get yourself into a cycle, sometimes you can't break out of
it. It's very easy to do.
Absolutely. Sorry, kids, everybody gets $5 for Christmas. Great to see you, Josh.
Yes, thanks so much, Amy.
How can our viewers find you?
We have lots of information on saving lots of money during Christmas at savingsangel.com.
Josh, you're the best. Thank you. All right, Bob, $5 for you, too.
Oh, I appreciate it. Thank you so much. Here's $5. I forgot to wrap it. Consumer alert right now. It's a National Tax Security Awareness.